So good morning to everyone. And normally there is when I come here there is someone who introduce me to the public. I am Alessandro Di Petrillo and I work for the largest company for aesthetic medicine and aesthetic surgery in Italy. I'm the second operator for a number of surgical acts and just intervention over the patient. What happened in the last 3 years is that our main field of interest shifted from aesthetic surgery and aesthetic medicine overall to regenerative medicine. I saw on the program that I should talk about, it's written on the program that I will talk about PRP, but actually I will talk a little bit about PRP and more I will focus over what is our main business, which is the mixture of lipofilling and PRP. Especially our studies on why it works, how it works, and what we can do to make lipofilling and the regenerative act works better. So, we start from the definition that you can see that the term regenerative medicine is was actually formulated just a few years ago, 25 years ago, by this man, William Hazeltine, which sold even is a professor at Harvard, and sold after his the Human Genomic Science to Glaxo. So what actually we do with regenerative medicine? This regards aesthetic, this regards orthopedic surgery, this can regards plastic surgery on all the field. What we do is to use our mechanism, our physiological mechanism, to improve the function of a tissue. Of course, in aesthetic, and especially fascial aesthetic, it means neoangiogenesis, neovascularization, more volume, but always using our own bricks, our own tissues. So first of all, why we shifted to regenerative medicine? The first reason is because it gives more beautiful result, because this is where we start at the beginning. You can see that even on very famous people, during the year there are changes. In this case, Angelina Jolie, we can see that there was actually an improvement with surgery. But a lot of times, there is no improvement, but a detrimental action of this kind of acts over the patient. This is Donatella Versace, and very probably she's got all the money in the world to have the best specialists in the United States, in Italy, in London, everywhere. But as you can see, the results are not exactly brilliant. So normally, even to the patient, we show Raffaello at the beginning. This is the Madonna Sistina. Why we show that? Because in Italian Renaissance, there was a sort of a cult for classical measure. You can see that there were the golden ratio, there was the base for Raffaello to create good face. The concept is that as they, in the Italian Renaissance, they were respecting some of this proportion, an aesthetic surgeon and an aesthetic doctor should always respect the proportion of the patient face. So you can see that this is a very famous image. To do these faces, Raffaello was just constructing the draw of the face inside around the circle. But if you do that on, you can see on normal faces, even the most beautiful, like Negroni, these are the results. So, of course, as most of you know, big part of getting older is losing fascial volume. Even Raffaello knew that, because this is Julius II. And to make him look older, he was just actually make the face more empty. This is the MERS scale, and as you can see, with the time, as time goes by, we lose volume over the face. This is the first patient that I showed. She was quite an important patient, because she was just, we were treating her at the beginning of a shifting from aesthetic medicine two regenerative medicine. As you can see, actually, she got not so prominent zygoma, and she wanted even big lips. The lips were actually treated with just standard hyaluronic acid, but the rest of the face we treat just with PRP and fats. And of course, the zygoma we created are a little bit harmonic, not too much bold. So in regenerative medicine, these are the instruments we got and the instrument we will talk about. PRP now we use mostly because we mix with the fats. The fats can give volume to a tissue, for example in the breast or in the face or in the calves or in the gluteal region. And when we want to give volume with the fat, the term is microfat. The microfat is the fat tissue that is just taken in the most conservative way, just to give the volume of the fat tissue to other acceptable sites. The nanofat, instead, is exactly the opposite. Is when we want to use just the regenerative action of the fat without volume. More before the fat, there are written in this image even another product that was very important for us because it was actually the first shifting to regenerative medicine. It is a product that is called cellular matrix. There is basically the mixing of a special hyaluronic acid with PRP. In this case, the hyaluronic acid is not exactly used to give volume. It's not a filler. It is a hyaluronic acid that makes some modulation of the relaxing of growth factor by the plates. So other classical image, this is a painting by Thiebaud. It's called the Charlene. In here, there is someone who is selling snake oil. He's selling snake oil for the plaque. So of course, in the modern age, you can, especially in our field, in the more commercial field, you can just try to sell something to the patient, not knowing exactly what you're doing, not knowing if it happens or not. This is what we really should avoid to do. To do that, in our practice, we try to make as much studies as possible. Me, myself, I'm a maxillofacial surgeon, so I would, even in the past, I was having very deep and university level of studies. Now, in our private practice, we try to do the same with publication and even our private studies over cadaver, for example. So, internet is full of this. Just this term is just like that time. Miracles, stem cells. I saw someone told me that yesterday another doctor was talking about the mixing of PRP and fat in the lacrimal region. So some other doctors were asking why it works. We are studying exactly that. So you can see there are a lot of very interesting sites that they make big promise. How we try to avoid that is just a charlatan act, the regenerative medicine, using the proper tools. We have a very deep partnership with the Regen Lab, which probably you heard about this. It's a Swiss company that they make the tools for our PRP. They work all around the world in different fields, and we are part of this partnership to study the new regenerative medicine tools that are available in all fields of medicine. We work with Tulip because they created a custom-made cannula that we will see later how it works and why we do that, to ensure the best action of the fat possible. We will see after how it works. This is a even starting from the tool, we are using exactly the opening of the cannula, which are custom made, the disposition of the holes in the cannula, which are custom made, the depth of the diameter of the cannula is custom made, and we will see why after. This is a new prototype of a kit for fat cleaning that we are creating. We are developing even with Regen Lab, and we will see After we will see why we use it. So we start from our first tool, that was the hyaluronic acid with the PRP. This product is just very simple. You just take the blood sample from the patient. There are inside some hyaluronic acid, which is very specific. It's not considered hyaluronic acid, so it's not supposed to last a lot. But as I told you, it is supposed to modulate the release of growing factor by the blades. What is very important talking about the remittive lab are some specific characteristics that it has. They are not kits that they concentrate a lot the blades. They concentrate four times the physiological concentration of the blades, but it is very specific over the deflection of the red blood cells, and it is very, very useful for that, for our use. How it works, this tool, is very simple. You just collect some blood. Then you take, just make the anticoagulant, that is sodium citrate, works all over the tool. You can see that on the bottom, so here it is this specific hyaluronic acid at the beginning. This is just it is a gel, a separating gel. You make very careful centrifugation. There is even a centrifuge which is specific for the Regen kit. You ensure the correct balance. There is even a protocol for the centrifugation, which must be respected. And at the end, you can see that all the red blood cell will finish here. Here the separation gel, and here there is the PRP and the hyaluronic acid. So at the beginning, of course, they are separated, but then gently inverting, homogenizing the flacon, you will have this mix that can be used. How? We have our protocol. We use 2.5 milliliter syringe, and overall, how we use now this product. This product we use a lot between a fat session and another. Normally our patient, they do at least one or two sessions of fat inside 1 year. Why they do that? Because we do a very easy and patient-friendly fat graft. That is very fast. Normally we take 20 minutes, 25 minutes to do the whole face. It's a little bit longer, we need more fat, for example, for the breast. But normally, between one fat and another, we use this product, which is loved by the patient. If used in the way we use, then we will talk about how to not use this product. It's really safe stuff, because it's PRP with just basic hyaluronic acid. It's just important to not take too much sun or go through sauna after that. The technique of injection are the same that we were using for aesthetic medicine. I am one of the main authors of this volume, Injecting in Aesthetic Medicine, that is actually the third most sold volume by Springer in all around the world. We are even, they have made them in Chinese, now it's editing the Korean language. To say that the techniques are almost the same, from filler to regenerative medicine. Why? Because we wanted to have an approach that was very patient-friendly and was very easily sold to the patient. So basically the techniques are very, very similar, just the cannulas are a little bit bigger. But it's just like a next step from aesthetic medicine. These are our number, probably at least 90,000 treatment in our company, maybe like 20,000 or something like that. Technique of injection, very, very simple, very simple to, very similar to a filler. We just use some injecting points in which we do some local anesthesia, and from then we use blunt cannulas to move inside the tissues and to release the product. We do the same with fats, or with fillers, or with this product, with the PRP. Still, to understand where to inject and on which layer to inject, We did several studies that I will show you later. So, for example, in the malar area, we must avoid the secondary genital branch of the zygomatic nerve. And we studied on, we do some, even some courses over cadavers to exactly, we will see later, this green line actually colored fats that we will see after in which layers we work. But of course, for every product, we try to see what is the plane we inject, how to reach that plane, and for which structure must be avoided. This is the zygomatic nerve that actually in 10-15% of the time is destroyed in aesthetic procedures or in the surgical branch, but it, much more important is to stay far from this, but we will see later. Oh yes, we have. This is the secondary genital branch. Later we will see how to make this with this green colored fat that this works in the lacrimal region and gives very, very good results. Again, the two nerves. And this is then what we do on the patient. At the beginning, this is the representation, blunt canvas, something very simple, really. We teach them to dermatologists, the general practitioners. But what is important is that we know why we teach that, because we studied on all the layers. So this is a 27 gauge canvas to use with several affixes. This is here. From this point of injection, we move. Sometimes, probably not on this patient, but you can work in the temporal region. Sometimes you can work in the frontal region for expression wrinkles. We make some local anesthesia, and I repeat, the procedure is exactly the same with fat, we'll see later. And then from there, we create a little hole in the skin. In this case, it is a 26 gauge needle. For fat, we use 22 gauge canvas and 21 gauge needle to create a little opening in the skin plane. And then we go inside with a blunt canula. And then we go. We just move the canula. It's not sharp, so you can't move. You must push forward, pull rearward, push forward in the several dimensions. And from very few points, you can reach actually the part of the face we are more interested in. So you can see the cheeks after a little bit of massage, and we go on. With several matrix, all around Europe, there were a little bit sometimes of hyper-reaction of the skin when used with very, very short needles, mesotherapy needles. So on the in this case, we wanted to study where we put this product. You will see a sort of lilac. It is a lilac-colored cellular matrix, which is injected with, again, with just a 27-gauge cannula, even in the temporal place. We do a temporal incision, then a lifting-type incision on the cadaver, and you can see we are just in the subcutaneous level. There are a lot of dermatologists that normally tell me, but PRP must be done in the deep dermis. We don't do like this. Personal formation, I'm a surgeon, and we work on this layer. Patients are very satisfied, and the results are quite good, actually. So on several matrices, we work over this level. Just starting from exactly the same point you saw before over the patient. And now we arrive to our main tool, which is fat, the mix of fat and PRP. There is still micrograph, nanograph. Micrograph, what does it mean? It means a fat which is very preserved in this ultrastructure, must be preserved because it must be attached from a donor site to another site far from the body. Of course, key points. A lot of people does the fat. We have our way to do that. Is local anesthesia, is around 20-30 minutes long. It is harvested with a small cannula and injected with a small cannula. And you see why.
Sorry, but the time is again the time of the presentation. Sorry.
So
20 minutes. It's now.
I will try to be very, very fast.
Yes, but we have a big delay, I'm sorry. Try to be very fast.
Okay, so even the nanographs are different. It's different. The adipocytes are not respected. We just want to have them a very some regenerative processes. Okay, so it's actually the presentation is very long, but we will try to, if you just see the key points, it just always the micrograph and the nanograph are always mixed with 20% of PRP. What we consider is the fat as a chain. We try to respect every step of the fat grasping. So if one of the link of the chain is weak, and the chain is this, fat harvesting, removal of blood, the mixing with PRP, if one of these link is weak, then all the chain just destroys. So we saw the cannula is special, it's 2 millimeter long. Why? Because we have ultrastructural studies over the factories more respect to a standard Coleman cannulas. Why? There are a lot of studies that show that. So all the characteristics of our cannula are just studies over the literature. It is very important to consider another chain, which is the negative pressure we generate while we take, while we harvest the fat. So it is very good, there are some pressure that increase independently from the gauge of the piston of the syringe, but only on how much we pull the piston rearward while we take. Normally it's good to push the maximum from 5 cc. To have at 5 cc we have half an atmosphere of negative pressure. Another problem is the washing. Why we must wash the fat? Because it is mixed with blood, so hemoglobin digestion can take to oxidation and detrimental action over the fat. But there is even the cytotoxicity of anesthesia that can compromise the attachment of the fat. To do that, we are studying the system with because the red blood cells are much more smaller than adipocytes, with ultrafiltration. We use a 40 micron filter to ensure that only the red blood cells, they goes away. It is some kits that we can show sometimes. No, not this time, there is no workshop. Infection for us is not a big problem. We are developing a rosette system to reduce even this problem.
I'm very sorry, but we are very late and you have to put in
less. I will just show some patient then, okay?
Less than 1 minute, I'm sorry.
Okay. So I just want to show we go away on the other part, but to answer why it is needed PRP with fats, because this is how the fat attach. They need factor from the plates to attach and develop new vascularization. All the keys are here, the right diameter of the fat we inject. You need special tool, special camera to not do this, which is standard Coleman technique. And I will just show that this is our lips after 24 hours of the treatment. So it's not like in the Coleman level filling. The patient can just go on the street and do what he does. Here is still, there are further studies, but since we don't have time to see how we study the thickness of the fat we must do. We study the volume exactly of the fat in this particular part, the lacrimal, the lacrimal gland, that would be actually very interesting to tell. So we calculated over the cadaver actually that ideal part of fat to be injected here is half a cc. we studied even the difference of all. These are the results, so I write the final part, which are very good. These are all the photos are at least 6 months after the fact. So you can see very natural results, but longer lasting. Of course, for you, that most of you are surgeons, you can mix it with surgery, still with very good results and very fast procedure. Reduction of cost, of course, is dramatic economical consequence. You can even work with scars or over breast because you're plastic surgeons. Over the nose for small office procedures. Or over the scars. This is a radiotherapy scar after 6 months and two procedures of fat. Of course, we have an international school for that. We have people coming from all around the world, from Johannesburg, from Oslo. But I'd like even to invite you to some of our cadaver courses. And I'd like that the staff at Marbella will organize even some courses here for someone that just wants to learn our technique. So thank you. Thanks for the
attention. Yes, it could be done with more time.
Yes, I know that.
Sorry that I have to, that we are very late.
Anyway, for any question we can talk here, or I will be later at the Marbella stand. So,
I see. Thank you very much. Now, there's a session with the